I'm Bob Hallmark in Longview. Let's talk charitable organizations today. More precisely, charitable organizations that have resale shops. Now, East Texans are very generous and they very often give donations of very high quality items to these resale shops, which has spawned another industry, repurposing. It has become so big that charitable organizations can actually see a profit from people that come in looking for items specifically to repurpose. And that's what brings me here to Longview today, here at Mercy Manor, which is a charitable organization that helps the needy. And we're going to talk to the director now, Stephanie Fears.
Hello. Hi.
First of all, I'm guessing you see lots of people coming in, particularly when you have a lot of high quality items that come in. You see lots of people coming in, I guess, shopping, looking for things that maybe they can turn over.
Yes, sir, we do. We have people come in that like to repurpose furniture, that like to repurpose books, repurpose clothes, things like that. And so this gives them the perfect place, and their purchases also in turn help us.
Now, if you look right over Stephanie's shoulder right here, you'll see that there's a hutch right behind her. And we were just talking about this. This is one of the more common items that you see that is repurposed. Hutches are very often turned into
Coffee bars. Mm-hmm. They'll remove the doors off of the hutches and fix them up and turn them into repurposed coffee bars.
Mm-hmm. Now, the beauty of this, as I see it, is that the charitable organizations, you actually make a dollar off of selling something, that maybe at a discount price. They, in turn, will repurpose it and sell it for a little bit more, but still at a discounted price from what they would get maybe from a name brand store, something of that nature.
Yes,
there's a benefit both ways here. Obviously, the money that you get from this goes to help the people that are needed in this case.
Yes, sir. The money goes to support those that we serve on a regular basis. It helps us to sustain the ongoing work that we do in our ministry home and within our classroom space for our community clients.
Jeff Carlson runs Helping Hands of Hawkins and often sees repurposers come in.
They buy things here inexpensively and they take them home and they do some wonderful things. They're very creative. Some people have shown me some of the things they've created, which is absolutely blows my mind how they can take what we would look at. Some people say, well, that's kind of, we haven't used that in years. Who would want anything like that? But they've taken it and repurposed it and made some very creative yard art, indoor art, people's imaginations is unbelievable when you see what the things that they can create in their mind just out of everyday things that people have discarded or don't need anymore.
Amy Sewell is a repurposer and finds hidden treasures in the resale shops.
Sometimes I just have to clean it up. Other times I have to paint it. You know, it just depends. If I just kind of have an eye for something that I can, you know, repurpose into something usable or make it nice again.
A lot of these items, if you look over Stephanie's shoulder, you'll see a lot of these items are very, very high quality here. And the one benefit here as well is these are things, if they were thrown away, would probably end up in a landfill. So I'm guessing you're glad that they end up here.
Absolutely. And one of the things that is super for us that we feel like is beneficial is that even a lot of our clients that we serve, because of us being able to repurpose somebody else's gently used item, some of our clients can come in here and buy something at such a discounted price that they're able to turn their home into just as quality a home as anybody else's, and but without like the mall price tag on there.
Gotcha. Mm-hmm. And obviously this is something that I don't hesitate to call it a trend because people obviously are making money at this and doing very well. But you get a unique item, something that has been repurposed that was quality in somebody else's home, now becomes quality in your home.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. That is wonderful.
And obviously, we do want to make a point here that the charities are utmost in all of this, is because they are the ones who actually put that money to work. The dollars that they make doing things like this, even selling items to be repurposed, mm-hmm. go to a very, very good cause here.
Yes, and I would even say, to take it a step further, we even employ some of our clients, previous clients, so that they are now earning an income for them and their new families. And so thrifting, this here has opened up so many doors to minister beyond the classroom, beyond the ministry home, but in our clients' pocketbooks as well.
Okay. Stephanie, thank you so much.
Thank you.
All right. And we'll have much more on this story tonight on KLTV 7 News for KLTV Web Extra. I'm Bob Hallmark.